Jesus was 100% God. No, he was not a junior God. He was 100%. So up to now, he is 100% God. Confidence that he must carry in God. Praise King Jesus. Even when the foundations are shaking, we stand on our word, because we are men who do not draw back to our petition. For the deliverance service, it is humiliation to what Christ did 2,000 years. It gives assurance in you. This is life. This is like we are in glory with Christ Jesus. With Christ Jesus, hallelujah! You and I shall be there, and we are going to be beside our Lord, because we were saved with eternity, no matter our shortcomings. Paul says that nothing shall separate us from the love of God, not even the things to come. From the simplicity that is in Christ. Any gospel that differs from the simplicity of Christ, it is none other than the gospel of deception. Demonstrate the anointing way deeper than any man has ever seen. Then let that man go deeper in the world.
Hallelujah, we welcome you for the Torch 047, hallelujah. And as we go into the word of prayer, I would love you to open up your heart and yield unto this, for there is something great that is going to be released tonight. There is something powerful that is going to be released tonight. Praise King Jesus. I want you to open up your heart, in that even as we pray, things start to work out for you. Even as we pray, your healing is delivered unto you. Even as we pray, your deliverance is brought close to where you are. Praise King Jesus. Even as you're watching us in your sitting room, in your bedroom, and in your car, I want you to share this live stream. I want you to invite people to watch this live stream. Praise King Jesus. I want you to tell people about Torch Fellowship. Praise King Jesus. As you're watching from our YouTube and you've not yet subscribed, I want you to subscribe to our YouTube and share the link. Share the link to your friends. Share the link to the people that you want to watch this sermon. Hallelujah. I want you to lift up your hands wherever you are. Lift up your hands wherever you are and worship God in your words. Worship God in your own words. Just speak to God. Just tell Him words of worship. Just tell Him words of worship right now. Manta lala kosa lebradosa. My God, you are worthy. You are glorious, oh God. You are glorious, my God. There is none like you, Jesus. There is none like you, my God. Radada kosa yala bradosa. Manta lira la bakosa la bradosi dededebosa. My God, you are worthy. You are glorious, oh God. You are glorious, oh God. You are highly lifted on high. You are glorified in this place, oh God. Shata yala bradosa, tayala bradosa. Manta lala la kosa yala bradosa. Manda rida la bakosi tayala bradosa. My God, you are worthy. My God, you are glorious. We glorify and exalt your name. Mantalala bakusa, tayala bradusa. For you gave Him a name that is above every other name, on the mention of a name, every knee will bend, every tongue confess that you are Lord. Mantalala kusa, la bradusa. Mandarida la bakusi, la bradusi, tayala mamandu zeta. My God, you are worthy in this place. Mantalala bakusi kaya. My God, you are highly exalted in our minister. Mandarida la bakusi. Bakusa Taya Labradusa. You are highly exalted, my God. Mandarida Labakusa. Mantala Kataya Labradusa. Take all the glory, take all the honor. Mantala Labakusa. Take all the praises, O God. You deserve it, O my God. Mandarida Bakusa Taya Labradusa. Mantala Kataya Labradusa. Radada Dakusa Taya Labradusa. I want you to worship God right now. Mandu Zita Yala Bradusa. Worship God right now. Mandu Zita Yala Bradusa. Rada Dakusa Tayala Bradusa. As you worship, there is something that is happening. Manda Rida Bakusa. As you worship right now. Manda Ridebusa Tayala Bradusa. You receive your breakthrough in the mighty name of Jesus. Rada Dakusa Tayala Bradusa. Manda Rida Lala Bakusa. My God, take all the praises, take all the worship. Manta Ridebusa Tayala Bradusa. Rada Dakusa Tayala Manduzete. Rida Dabayala Lala Lala. Mantale Brondozita. Ripragadusa Yala Bragadagada. Rede de Kusikayala Branduzita. Mantala Katayala Branduzande. Rada Dabakusikayala Manduzuta. Mantale Branduzita. Manda Rada Dabakusa. Rata Yala Pradusa. Manda Ziala Bakusikayala Manduzite. Rada Dadadakusa. Mantala Lala Kusa. Somebody worship God wherever you are. Mantale Rebusa. Worship God wherever you are. Manduzita Yala Bradusa. Rata Yala Branduzita. Manduzita Yala Bradusa. Mantala Katayala Baba. Rida Dakusa. Mantala Kataya. Mantala Bakusa. Riba Bakusa Tayala Mnanduzite. Manduzita Rada Baba. Rada Dakusa. Mantala Kataya. Mandaraba Bakusika. Rata Yala Branduzita. Rakata Katayala Baya. Mantala Katayala Bradusa. Mandazita Yala Bradusa. Rakaka Yala Dakaya. Manduzute Yanda Yala Lalaba. Manduzi Yala Bakusa. Rada Dakusi Yala Mama Mama. Manduzita Yala Bradusa. My God, my God. Manduzita Yala Baba Baba. Tonight you're encountering men like never before. My God, my God. Mantala Katayala Baba. Rodusi Yala Bradusa. Mantala Katayala Bradusa. Rakata Yala Mnaduzete. Shataya rakata kata rapranduzi kata mantala kata mantala pakata rapatakaya riprakatapa rapapataya rata roprotapayalate riprotosika mantala patakata manduzi kapaya matoli prakatapa ripapayalata riprokosa kata mantala katakata ramamakosa ratakatakaya matali prondazika robobosa mantala kata Mandozikata, Robobosa, Mantala Branduzuta, Robobosaya, Mandaraba Bakosa, Rakatakaya, Mantala Pradosa, Ratatakaya, Mantala Prakata, as you worship God, Mandariba Babakosa, Mandari Branduzia, Mantala Kataya, you receive your healing right now, as you worship God, Ratakaya La Pradosa, you receive the answers right now, Mantala Kataya, the power is available. Mandozi yala baba, the healing is available. Mandozi kayala baba. Matalakata, rapapata, rebebekosa. Your answer is available. Your breakthrough is available. Your healing is available. Matalakata, mandozikata, ramamakosa, ratakatakata, mandozikata, mandozita yala bradosa, mandarakata. The power is available. Mandozikata, the power is available. Mandozika yala baba, mandozikata yala baba. Child of God, now it is the time to manifest that which God blessed in the inside of you. Now is the time to manifest the anointing that sits in the inside of you. Mantalakata. Somebody speak right now. Somebody speak right now. Ratataya rapataya. There is something you're manifesting right now. I want you to speak it out. Mantalakaya labosa. Mandoziya labakosa. As you confess out, it is manifesting right now by the power of the Holy Spirit. As you speak out your healing right now, it is manifesting by the power of the Holy Spirit. Mando Zita Yala Bradosa. Rata Yala Brandosi Yala Baba. Shataya Rata Kataka. There is something that is breaking out right now. Rata Payalata. Something is breaking out right now. In our nation, something breaks out right now. Mandarakata Yala Bradosa. Mendozia, the glory of God breaks out in our nation, Uganda. Rema makosa, mandozika yala bradosa, rataka yala bradosa. The peace of God that surpasses the understanding of men breaks out in our nation. Mandozika yala bradosa, mandozika takata, robosa tayala bradosa. I want you to speak peace in that situation. Mandozika yala bradosa, rama makosi yala bababa. In the seasons of terror that you're in, I want you to speak peace right now. Mando sita yala bradosa, mando sika yala bababa, rada da kosa, mando si yala bababa. I want you to speak that peace right now. Manta la bradosa, mando sita yala bradosa. Shata yara baba ratakata rama makosa. I want you to speak right now, my friend, child of God, speak it out right now. I want you to speak out your healing. I want you to speak out your deliverance. I want you to speak out your breakthrough right now by the power of the Holy Spirit. Mata la pradosa, unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above beyond that which we ask or think about. Rapatakata mata la prakata yalade mando zikataka. Matala Pradosa, Rada da Konda, Matala Pradosa, Matala Kata, Robosa, Matala Pakata, Mantore Brondasika, Matala Papayalata, Mando Zotaya. Your healing is available, Matala Baba. Your breakthrough is available, Mando Zika Yala Baba. The power is available to transform your life, Manda Rababakosa Yala Pradosa. The answers that you need are available, Mando Zotaya La Pradosa, Rada da Konda. My God, Robosa Yala Baba Baba, my God, Romando Zika Yala Bradosa, Matala Katakata, your healing the sick, O God, your delivering the bound, O God. Matalakata rababakosa matalakata ya rababakosa ya matala brando zinda randa da kosa ya bradosa manda rakataka ya. It is our confidence, O God, that tonight you raise the dead. It is our confidence tonight, matalabakosa, that the blind see, matale brodosa. It is our confidence, O God, matalababakosa, that the lame regain back their strength to walk, matalabakata rababakosa ya la bradosa. Mando Zoyala Babakonda, Mantala Kata, Mando Zikata, Matala Pradakata, Robobo Sata Yala Kata, Matala Brando Zonde, Mando Zinda Yala Babakosa, Radada Babakosa, Matala Kata, my God, you are worthy, my God, you're worthy, Manda Redebosa Yala La 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 La. Shataya matalakata mando zikaya manda rererebosa. They are people that you're being healed right now. You're being cured of any kind of disease. Matalakata yala bradosa rakataka yala bradosa. For we believe a report that is of no man. Matalegadosi yala la babakosa. We believe a report that is of God. Radadakosi kaya la bradosa. Matalakata kaya. Where there is death, I speak life. Matalabakosa. Where there is been darkness, I speak light in the name of Jesus. Rata yala brandozika rada da kosa matala kataya la bradosa rede de kosi kaya la baba. Where there's been sorrow, I speak happiness in the name of Jesus. Rabata kataya matala prataka yala ta manda rebe bekonda yala bradosa rada kosi yala bakonda yala bayagade romo munda zia mandala kataya matala bakata robobosa matalakata ribrokotaka matale pronda zika rama mama makosa rede de kosa osha raba baba makosa. My God, raba baba kosi da. Shataya la pradosa rada da da kosa matalakata. I thank you, God, rede de kosa. I thank you for that which you've done. I thank you for that which you've done in us, O God. Ratatayalata. I thank you for the dead that are risen. I thank you for the lame that are walking. I thank you for the blind that are seeing. I thank you for the deaf that are hearing right now in the name of Jesus. Matalakataya. I want you to thank God wherever you are. Thank God for what he has done in the inside of you. Thank God for what he has done. Manta labakosi kaya la bradosa mando zita yala bradosi kaya la bababa mando zete yere bradosa. I want you to thank God for the stirring up that you received right now. Manda riba bakosa rata kata kata kaya matala kata kaya la pata mando zikata yala bradosa. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, my friend. Thank you, my God. Radadakosa. Manta lapaka yala dosa. Manda redebosa. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, God. Manda rebebakunda. We thank you for the testimonies. Manta lakataya. We thank you for the testimonies. Manda ribabakosa. We thank you for the nations listening to our sound. Manta lapakataya. We thank you, my Savior. Manda redebekunda yala bradosa. Manta la kata yala pradosa. Manda rida la la bakosa yala la baba. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, my friend. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, mighty God. We thank you, mighty Redeemer. There is none, there is nobody like you, Father. There is none like you, God. None compares to you, Father. None compares to you, my God. Shara babakusa rabradusa. Manda rida rabakusa tayala bradagadagada. Rebebekusi kayala brandozita. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I want you to clap your hands wherever you are. Clap your hands to thank God. Clap them. Clap your hands to thank God for what He has done. Rata payala pradosa. I believe there is somebody you've received your healing. You've received your breakthrough. You've received your deliverance right now by the power of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want to remind you to share the link. Hallelujah. As we get into the preview of the previous Torch Fellowship. May God love you for us. Amen and amen. Put in prison, Jesus came into Galilee preaching the gospel of the kingdom of God and saying, the time is fulfilled and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent ye and believe the gospel. And that word was given dominion over the earth. That's why he says, I have come to establish this. Repent, flee from what you believe that is right, and come to this knowledge. Because it's in this knowledge that you have the access to the kingdom. That's why he says, I am the way,
the truth,
and the life. Which means he is the very way of the kingdom. So we are not going to trust for that. No, he did not come to give us this way. He came to show us that he is the way. He came to show us that for you to enter into the kingdom of the Father, which is Christ, you have to enter into Christ. So when you enter into Christ, you enter fully into the kingdom. Because when you are in Christ and is in you, you are established.
Yes.
That's why the kingdom of God, if you're to go to Revelation, the Bible says that we are going to stay here when Jesus is the king and we are co-heirs.
Some men do not even right now believe fully in the liberties of the Spirit. Whom the Son sets free is free indeed. Is free indeed. And then somebody just gets this scripture. Whoever the Son sets free is free indeed. And then you find them in the certain corner. Some people are still repenting up to the generation of Adam. Can you imagine? Kati Adam akwatira kowa. Waliyonga adiye chivala.
For sure.
Adam akwatira kowa. Are you really in this kingdom? Are you really into this life that you are speaking about? Is there no condemnation for those who are in Jesus Christ? Therefore now, it means, that statement simply means, the moment you repent and you believe, there is a certain chapter of life that is started there and then.
Another closes. Actually, you look at this New Testament and Old Testament. You know, if you're the reader of the scriptures, you will understand what I'm trying to mean. You see, God shows us these things, but we just don't want to understand. You see, before you go to the Old Testament, to the New Testament, there is a blank page. This is not literature. This is not literature. We are reforming. We are bringing in a reformation. That's why God was quiet for these 400 years.
You see, man of God, In fact, these years, God was quiet. And exactly, this is what happens to a person who has accepted Jesus Christ. In fact, everything the laws, everything that the Lord has been having against you, the moment you repent, God keeps quiet and starts forgetting.
I see that revelation. My God.
He keeps praise that because he keeps quiet. He keeps quiet. Then when you believe in your heart, starts a new chapter.
New Testament. Marita.
Then he gives you your lineage. The book of the generation of Jesus Christ.
Exactly, we start.
we start speaking about the new you. These are the things.
We don't have Adam. We don't have Adam in this generation. We don't.
Talim.
He was promising them Christ. Because in Christ we don't have sickness. When he says, "None in Zion shall say I am sick." What is the meaning of Zion? None in this kingdom. Zion is a kingdom. When he says, "None in this kingdom shall say I am sick," Israelites have been sick. We've read of sick people in the scriptures. We've read about them, and they were sick. But now in the kingdom he was promising, none shall say I am sick, which means that not even sickness will dwell. That even if you would love to have sickness, you will not even have the space to say, "I am sick." It's not even a place of confession, Pastor David. No. It is a place of even where you want to confess, you cannot confess because it can't happen. That's why he says, "By his stripes we were healed." Now, before we entered into the kingdom, we were subjected into the sufferings of Christ. The pain he had, we had it. The death he had, we had it. Now we rose. Now if Christ cannot fall sick, I cannot fall sick. I say it in the middle of this broadcast. I cannot be sick. There is no place you're going to find me in Mulago that I'm bedridden. No, it's not possible. He is in heaven.
So are we.
So if God cannot be poor, and the Bible says gold and silver belong unto him, man of God, gold and silver belong unto me. Whatever God is, I am. Whatever God is, if he's immortal, we are not taking it back. If you think we are going to repent about it, no, we are not taking back our words. Let me tell you, if God is immortal, by the way, scriptures provide a space of immortality. You know, preachers always preach all things, but they forget to preach about life because they say everyone is meant to die. Where is it written? I've searched scripture and it is not written anywhere that all of us have to die for Jesus to return. No, there are people that were caught up. Why don't I wait for rapture? Why do I need to be among the people that raised from the graves? Praise the Lord. Praise Jesus. If Methuselah. Look at the man. He doesn't have any record, actually. Any serious record of understanding God. Actually, as they are giving us in Hebrews 11, he's not anywhere.
And by the man of God, you can decide in this kingdom. Because, for example, look at this man who received Jesus Christ, Simeon. The guy was like, "I'll never die, not until I see the Lord." Kato, why yes, yandi zari bram mubiri kumi. Omusajo to yandi.
Yandi mulage. Yandi mulage. That's why when he sees Jesus, he says, "I can now rest." Banange, we are being given a free will in the kingdom of God because we are co-heirs. We are crown princes waiting for the appearing of our Lord, that we might govern with him, that we might be given our crowns. Now, the crowns that we are waiting to receive, we are already crown princes. We make decisions. We are princes. We have councils.
You can create a council in your finances. The moment you join this kingdom, there are certain things you're meant to place in order. These things of going to the prayer mountain, breaking bondages. I hear in my family, there are no weddings. No, no, that's not your family now. There is a family that God has blessed you in. In this kingdom, marriage is not a problem. In this kingdom, money is not a problem. In this kingdom, sicknesses are far from us. In this kingdom, death is not a problem. We have the antidote of death. We know how to defile death. We know how to defile cancer. We know how to defile tumors.
Praise the Lord, people of God. I want to welcome you to this wonderful edition of the Torch Fellowship. I want to thank God that you're tuned in from wheresoever you are watching from. And my prayer for you today is that may the Spirit of the Lord fulfill all your heart desires. As you're watching, may the Spirit of God quicken you. And I pray that you're attentive to understand whatever I'm going to share. Before I share, I want to pass on these simple announcements. On the 30th of December, this very month that we are in, actually happy new month, this very month that we are in, on the 30th, we are going to have an overnight, which is 2021 to 2022 prayer night. It's going to be the Revival Call Night 7. And I believe it's prophetic for it to be Revival Call Night 7 as we are entering into the year of revival. Praise the Lord. And I believe that the Spirit of the Lord shall open our sight to whatever He is planning to do in that night. It's the night that we are going to be entering into 2022. We are entering 2022 in advance. Praise the Lord. So we shall be live on Lighthouse Television. That is from 10:30 p.m. to 4 a.m. 31st of December. So I request you all to inform your friends and invite them to this wonderful cause in the mighty name of Jesus. And I have some testimonies. We have a Brian that received Christ. I think it's Brian or Bran. Then we have Rose, cancer. Praise the Lord. This was Mulago. We have TB, Kasule. Praise the Lord. Then we have William, accident. Praise the Lord. We believe God for greater things. We always have outreaches in Mulago, and we believe we are soon communicating a day that we are planning to have a fellowship with those people at least once a week. Praise the Lord. On the 25th of December, we have a charity outreach. And feel free, as led by the Spirit of God, we want to share with the street people of Katwe. We want to share Christmas with them. So the way you're led to give in for this cause, you can give in as led by the Spirit of God. We are going to feed with them. We are going to preach to them. And we are planning to write down some notes for them in Luganda so that they can be able to understand that they should not only receive Christ, but they should also be able to understand the Christ they've received. Praise Jesus. So I want to thank God for that. And I want to thank God for you that are giving. Now, our giving lines are displayed on your screen. And if you're led to give in the name of Jesus Christ, I request you to give as led by the Spirit. For the Bible says that as a man purposes in his heart, let him give. So I want you to give your tithing, your offering on our numbers, our Airtel, our mobile money number. You can give in as led by the Spirit. Let me pray for you. Father, I thank you for the people that are giving in right now. Father, expand them, multiply them. They shall never lack. Even those that would love to give and are not able to give, may lack never come their way. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Today I'm going to talk about something that is crucial in our stature today, in our present status of life. You know, one thing as a Christian, there is a lifestyle you always ought to live in. And there is a lifestyle you always need to be assumed in. When I talk of assumed, what people assume you are. Now, that
lifestyle that people assume you to be, you are meant to be it. Not the bad one, but the good one. But there is a place for a Christian where you are made. There is a place for a Christian where you are planted and watered. And in this place, it's where you grow. In this place, it's where you yield. And in this place, it's where you expand. Praise the Lord. So today I was led by the Spirit of the Lord to talk about a simple topic called assurance in prayer. What is your assurance in prayer? When you pray, how assured are you that your prayer is answered? How confident? How persuaded? How eloquated are you that this thing has been answered? This thing is working. Praise the Lord. And I want us to first go to the book of James, chapter 5, verse 16, says, confess your faults one to another and pray one for another that ye may be healed. Praise the Lord. It says, the effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. 16. It says, Elias or Elijah was a man subject to the like or to like passions as we are. Same passions, same knowledge, same understanding. Praise the Lord. As we are. And he prayed earnestly that it might not rain, and it rained not on earth by the space of 3 years and 6 months. And he prayed again, and the heaven gave him rain, and the earth brought forth her fruit. The writer James informs us that as we believers, we should pray for one another. But he speaks of a place of confessing. Now, I am not discouraging congregations, or I'm not discouraging prayer partners, but I want to teach you a personal place of personal prayer. A prayer place where you go and you expect results to bring forth fruit. He gives an example of Brother Elijah, who was of the old dispensation but had a mind of a new believer, a mind of the new saint. He says, Elijah, who had the same passion, the same desire, the same knowledge that you have right now of having an answered prayer. He says that the prayer of this fervent man, the reason why you are sharing your request, the reason why you are sharing, you're confessing your prayer request unto this person you're confessing to, it's because they are righteous and they carry a fervent prayer. Now, what is your assurance in this prayer? The fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much, and that is our assurance. So who is this righteous man? The righteousness that we are talking about that makes up this man, it's their faith in Christ Jesus. Remember, the righteousness of a believer that is of a New Testament, it is measured on how they believe in Christ, not by how they operate. When I talk of operation, I'm talking of their actions and their works. So the ways of a faithful man, the prayer of a man that trusts in God, availeth much. So you will ask yourself that why is this prayer not working out? Because we have people that have prayed for jobs year in, year out. They prayed for a job in 2019. They prayed for a job in 2020. They have been praying for a job in 2021. And up to now, on their prayer requests of 2022, they still write down that they need a job. What is the problem that their prayers are not heard? What is the problem, or that their prayers are not manifested or brought to life? The Bible said that confess your faults one to another. Now, you will create another personality with whom you are going to confess your problems. You are going to confess your sickness. You are going to confess your results and all things. Now, I can choose my pastor. As a pastor, I'm doing that. But there is a person of the Holy Spirit who is available to listen to us and give us a result immediately. So what if that another person replaced the Spirit of God? You look yourself up and confess, because there is power in a confessing tongue. You know, there is power in your tongue. When you confess something, there is something that is produced. That's why in the beginning, when God was creating the world, he confessed things out. He called them out. The Bible says he called for light. He pulled it out. Now, his calling was the word that he spoke. Let there be was the power of confession. He confessed it. So prayer cannot be prayer when it's not confessed. I'm not disagreeing with what Christ said, that don't be like the hypocrites, who go on the streets and then they shout out that people may know that they are praying or that they are fasting. What I'm trying to mean is when you go to your secret place, realize the power of blabbing out that which you want God to do. No, you are not just merely confessing it, but you're confessing behind there is a belief. That's why the Bible says that the prayer of this righteous man, the fervent prayer, the working prayer, availeth much. So if your prayer does not avail much, one, you need to check the God you believe, you need to check your faith, and you need to check the way you believe. Praise God. One thing I realized as I was reading was the example he gave. I realized that it was not in the plans of God to stop the rain as Elijah wanted. But because Elijah was a righteous man, his prayer availed something. That when he stood up and spoke to the heavens and told the heavens that withdraw your rain, for the next 3.5 years, I don't want to see any drop from you. The heavens obeyed him because his prayer was fervent. Now, what makes a prayer fervent? The boldness with which you speak these things. When I talk of boldness, I'm not talking of you going and then you start saying, you rise up and walk, and then the lame man refuses. No, I'm talking of the boldness of the Holy Ghost. I'm talking of the boldness of the Holy Ghost. Praise King Jesus. So you realize that Elijah had something in him, that all his prayers he made were giving us results. Maybe Elijah is far. Let us assess Peter. Peter reaches a place in life where even his shadow was healing the sick. Remember, why are we praying? He has told us that we are praying for one another to be healed. We are praying for one another that our faults might be revanished, might be removed upon us. So why are you praying right now? Why are you tuned in this Tuesday, this Friday? Why are you tuned in? Why do you always go to church on Sunday? Why do you always go for the prayer altars on Monday, on Wednesday, on Friday? Why are you always on? Because you're seeking for a certain answer. But why are you not getting this answer? Why is it that you're the one that has prayed years and years and nothing is manifesting? You fasted. You've gone to prayer mountains. You've been in prayer ministries overnights. You've done all things that a man can do, but nothing is happening. Is it that you've not believed? No. You've sown seeds. But why is that very prayer point you've had taken long? Because according to God, if you're to go to the book of Matthew, listen. He says, but when you pray, use not vain repetitions as the heathen, for they think that they shall be heard for their much speaking. Be not ye therefore like unto them, for your Father knoweth what things you have need of before you ask him. As I've told you, you've asked for healing. Ever since you got HIV, you've gone prophet per prophet, apostle per apostle. They tell you that there is another one here, you run. They tell you there is a healing minister here, you run. They tell you abroad, you run. But why isn't that HIV going? Yet you've prayed. Whenever you go on your knees, you praise God, cleanse my blood from this virus. Cleanse my blood from this HIV. Cleanse my blood from cancer. Cleanse my blood from diabetes. And all these have been your prayers. But I say that don't be like the heathen who make repetition of their prayers. As though God has not heard. Yet the God you are asking for knows what you are to ask for even before you ask for it. You have repeated prayers as though God is not hearing. You have gone prophet. Actually, you have called almost every pastor you know. And the ones they are even still telling you. But no result. No result. And I want to address that issue. Let me give you my testimony. Once I pray for something, it's hard for me to repeat it again. Because I believe, once I pray and I believe, I have received. Because whatsoever I'm going to ask, he has already availed it unto me. He has already given it unto me. Praise the Lord. So, I want to open up somebody's eyes. Have you ever thought of the supremacy of God? Have you ever thought of the aspect of God or the characteristic of God, the character trait of God called Almighty? Have you ever thought of that? Before I go on my knees, the first aspect, the first characteristic of God that comes to me, I know that I am bowing before the Almighty God. And that assurance that I go in with, it's what God answers. If you're a reader of the Bible says in the book of Mark 11:24, it says, therefore I say unto you, what things soever you desire, when you pray, praise the Lord, believe and you receive them and you shall have them. Which means whatever you have desired, when you open up your mouth before God to pray, you have received. It's what you believe. And that belief of you receiving it is what God answers. So in simple terms, God is not going to answer your prayer. God is going to answer your belief. Praise God. So the faith you go in with, it is what determines what will be the result of your prayer. That's why he says, whatsoever things you desire, pray, believe, and you shall receive them. us go to pray when they are not even as well. Actually, there is one that even goes and says, I'm going to fast and pray for 3 days that God might be able to place a favor upon me. The way he placed a favor upon Esther. You know, Esther prayed and fasted for 3 good days and appeared before the king and obtained favor. What? Let me tell you this. Have you ever thought of what God can do in a blink of an eye? Eh? Let me tell you. In the first day, the Bible says, what did he do? As the Spirit was moving upon the face of the world. Praise the Lord. And the world did not have any form. It was voidless. Praise the Lord. What did he do? He commanded light. It did not take 10 days. It did not take a minute. The Bible says, and light appeared. And God saw it was good. And you're telling me the God that created the whole light, the God that created the sun and the stars in one day, that cover the whole face of the world, can fail to provide an answer to you in a second. Remember, his word is available to answer. The Bible says he just sent only his word and it healed them all. So this same word that healed them all has the capability to say that your sickness is healed. It has the capability to say that your job is secured. It has the capability to say that your ministry is secured. Praise the Lord. Because this same word has come to work in us. That's why he says, whatsoever we shall ask and believe. The word believe there is having trust in the word and the promise of God. That's why I always tell people, I don't always have a plan B. Because once I take issues before my God and I place them before him and I ask, I'm sure of an answer. I don't have a plan B. Because I know by all means, these things have to be answered. And let me tell you, there is nothing like, you know, there is a realm of prayers that are going to go to God direct. Come and we teach you how to pray so that prayers are answered direct. Come and we tell you that prayers, these ones will not be taken to God, these ones will be taken to God. No, unless you choose where to divert your prayer to. But so long as it's addressed to God, he answers all prayers from his children. All prayers are answered. No, let us go to Luke. He addresses that. Luke chapter 11, verse 10 to 13. He says, for everyone that asketh, does what? Receiveth. And he that seeketh, findeth. Praise the Lord. And to him that knocks, the door is done what? The door shall be opened. If a son shall ask bread, of any of you that is a father, will he give him a stone? Or if he ask a fish, will he give him an egg? Praise the Lord. Will he give him a snake? Praise the Lord. Or if he shall ask for an egg and offer him a scorpion? If ye then, being evil, know how to give good gifts unto your children, how much more shall your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to them that ask? Praise God. Amen. What have you realized that is different in this scripture? Shall he give the Holy Spirit to them that ask? Which means when you have the Holy Spirit, you have everything. When you have the Holy Spirit, you have everything. That's why I tell people, before you pray, know your position. You know, if you're to go and ask for food from maybe your boss, you know your position. You know what to ask for. You know what to ask for. Even as a son, I know what to ask for. So most of you, the problem why you have unanswered prayer, you are directed as servants. And if I'm to reply to a servant, I reply at my pace. But concerning your son, you reply as a father. That's why he says that I'm much more to your heavenly father. That means you're not addressing your prayer to your master, but you're addressing your prayer to your father. So there is no place where we are going to teach you how to pray. Because if I can't teach you how to relate with your earthly father, I can't teach you how to relate with your heavenly father. He's your father. The way I approach my father is different from the way you approach your father. So if we are to go to the place of understanding prayer, which is a place of communing with God. Now, I want to replace where there is God to commune with our Father. So if I'm asking for something from God, I am assured of an answer. Because I have the Holy Spirit, which works in the inside of me. Whenever he desires something, even before I pray, he has given unto me, because he has provided all things that pertain to godliness. Praise God. Amen. Teaching good tonight. Yeah. Let me tell you, children of God, we are going to a place as the church where we will not even have time of playing around with certain things. Christians that don't have jobs, such prayer requests, food. Let me tell you, it's not that we are bragging, but it's a place of us understanding. I know food can become scarce. Sentene zibula, you don't have food, you don't have rent. But if you are a non-believer, we can believe on your behalf. But if you're a Christian and you have accepted Christ, me, I've seen people that send him locally, mwaka kumwaka, and nothing has changed on them. They pray every Monday, they pray every Tuesday, they pray every Wednesday, they pray every Thursday, they pray every Friday, they pray every Saturday, Sunday, they add on overnights. Then after Sunday after, they go to the prayer mountain. Sunday they come to church. They go back to the prayer mountain. Monday they come back. You get what I'm trying to mean? Is somebody understanding what I'm meaning? But they don't carry results. They don't. No labo muntu nga mwaka kumwaka sabye mbaga mwaka na yenge amazima bawa si saba la yasi gadao. Why? They have not understood the assurance they carry in prayer. He has said, the fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. So long as you entered into Christ, your prayer is fervent. Because the fervent prayer is for a righteous man. And it produces results. You cannot pray. Today I'm praying for this. The following day it's the same case. The other day it's the same case. No. Are you trying to tell me that God is not hearing you? You're among the category that Jesus has told us about. The ones that don't believe. Because if you believe, he has given you all things. The Bible says he blessed us with all spiritual blessings in the heavenlies. Praise the Lord. Even before the foundations of the world were laid, he had blessed us. Isn't the Lord wonderful? No, should we understand that? He has blessed us with all spiritual blessings. Not only a blessing of a wife. Not only a blessing of a husband. Not only a blessing of money. Not only a blessing of mention your need. Mention your need. But he has blessed us with all spiritual blessings. Even before the foundation, even before he said, let there be light, he blessed you. Even before he said, let there be this, even before he created Adam, even before he created Christ, he said he has blessed us with all that. So when we have the assurance, how do we pray? He says, with thanksgiving, make your requests known unto God. That is how a man of prayer prays. A man of faith, praise the Lord. With thanksgiving. You know, the reason why people are getting dissolved in lack, failure, it is because they've not yet reached that place of fully understanding what it means to trust the workings of God. You pray and don't receive. James still addresses that. Because you pray amiss. Some of you are not praying. You're not asking for that car because you have a lustful desire. Because he says you pray amiss or you have a lustful desire. So some of you, it's not a lust that you need that job. It's not lust that you need that marriage. Maybe you're 38. Maybe you're 40. And indeed, you need the marriage because it's the age of marriage. Actually passed. Some of you, you're 50 years. You don't have a child. It's not lust. But for all the years you ask for a child, why are you not having that baby? Are you saying God gave you breasts to just breastfeed the air? Or he gave you that womb just to walk around to feel a lady? No. Balokole tuino kutegera cheba ito kukiriza mukama. Tewari sala, no prayer that goes in doubt that is answered. The reason why Brother James tells us that you pray amiss, he's sure. You pray amiss, how? You make wrong prayers. I used to tell people some time back that the way you ask for sauce from your husband will determine which type of soup he's going to buy. For the women that are married that are watching, let me teach you this technique. You know, when you go and you want meat from your husband and you've been feeding on silver fish year in, year out, and you go like, fetukoye mukene, guagala tukutumale muri atufe. We are tired of this. Let us first die so that we are able to feed on another thing. How will you feed on it when you're dead? Find a way that is cunning. Sikiriza. Go, banange tata juni, engeri je wagula mwa kanyama lujabana baomerwa. Na fetwa omera. Ndoza nero tulie kanyama. The husband will be impressed. You need new bed sheets. Ndoza kana tusoka tumale gayuza. And you expect somebody to give you that. Be cunning. You go before God. Na ye mukama. Fetwa kola chi. Elfa babo na abona. Mwaka kumwaka. Fumbu fembunza. You're really confessing that you're dying of jiggers. Fire. Are you seeing how people pray? You find someone on a prayer mountain dying. Mukama, fewa fewa gamba, tatuli fumbirwa, awa fewa gamba, tewari wafuga motoka, na kamba suaze, na watika kase, kamba suaze, na watuulide. And you're like, you've taken all your transport to come to this mountain to confess that. One, you're praying wrongly. Two, you're after lust. You have to last. You know, believers, you need to watch yourselves. Praise the Lord. You need to watch yourselves. That's why he says, we started from James, praise the Lord, 5. And he told us that as we are confessing to one another, we are praying for we are praying in fervency, praise the Lord, in assurance. We are expectant of a positive result. But someone, I know, in 7 days God is going to do for me something. You know, one day I have somebody. Certain son of mine came to me and had visited the American embassy 5 times. I'm sorry to laugh, but it's funny. 5 times to the American embassy and is denied a visa. He even tried lottery. Praise the Lord. And this guy tells me, Nayem Kamanda Mukolachi, what did I do to God? I laughed and I didn't give him a reply up to now. But let me give you a reply right now, gentlemen. Have you read what the Bible says in Deuteronomy about nations? What did he do? He divided. Not so? And he gave us those nations. Everyone received his portion. Even you, you received. I cannot go to an embassy and they deny me a visa when I am meant to go there. It's impossible. Why? Ask of me and I will give you nations. Before you go, did you just remember God at the place where your paperwork was done and you're taking it to the consulate? Or you started with God? Because what he starts, he finishes. Some of you don't even start your journey with God. Someone called me, they were constructing a house, those ends of Busega. And this lady calls me and tells me, Apostle, I've been constructing my house for the last 5 years. And ever since we reached this stage, nothing is changing. I laughed. And I told the lady that, did you call me when you're starting? Or did you pray? She told me, amazima twata nikakubanga sente zaliwo. Why do you remember God in the course of the journey? We are meant to walk with him. That's why I always tell people, prayer does not mean you close yourself up for 40 hours. You close yourself up for 24. No. Prayer is our system of operation. Prayer is our engine. Prayer is our everything as Christians. I'm not meaning prayer is God, but prayer is the operating system of God in us. It's what stimulates the Holy Ghost. So I don't know how you've been praying, but try to believe that you have. With thanksgiving, make your requests known unto God. You don't need to go to a prayer mountain to declare marriage. Father, I thank you that I am married. I thank you for these 3 children of mine. You know, we don't see things as though they are. We see them as though they are meant to be. Apply scripture. Father, I thank you that I am the richest man in the world. Father, I thank you that things are turning around for me. I thank you that my job is secured. You know, nokera kumacha toina mulimu. I've applied to over 20 companies. Everyone is rejecting me. I have a spirit of rejection. Even the spirit, actually, I always tell people that spirit of rejection doesn't exist. It doesn't. Because if even Joseph was in our generation, we would say he had a spirit of rejection. I will tackle that another time. Let me conclude by telling you this. Children of God, listen and listen good. You know, there is this other thing I want to clear out. Now, later, something better. You know, most cases people answer for God. I already see those blue things on people's Facebook statuses, that God has a please wait, something better, not now, I have better plans. No. By the time I feel I need money, indeed I need it. So if I'm to ask God for what to eat and he tells me please tomorrow, yet my stomach is dying out, is that God? Yet he has told me that he has answered even before I prayed. And now you're telling me there is something better. Okay, I need that something better, but I need it now. You want to first die to touch of these things? Why do you know? Bananga tuleke kubuza abantu. Mukama taina no. Tajina no. God doesn't have a no. All things in him are what? A yes and amen. Period. There is no no. If you're to pray that let my neighbor die, God will ignore and the devil will reply. Akuraga kafe tutararogomuri nyeria Yesu. Oh. The Antichrist will come. Hallelujah. And say, oh, you want to kill? The Bible says you belong to your father who was a murderer from the beginning. And the murderer will do what? Will come and do his job. And then you come and give testimonies. I thank God that my workmate died and I'm promoted. My God. Such prayers are not answered by God. He will not reply. He will just neglect and the devil will do his part. Teaching good? So let us learn to understand and discern and know what is true for us. Let us learn to pray. Let us learn how to commune with God and get results out of prayer. Refuse to pray for 10 years for one thing. Refuse to pray for something for over years, months. I'm praying for you tonight that God is going to cause a quickening. All the prayers you've had for the past years that have not come to pass, may the Spirit of the Lord quicken it now in the name of Jesus. You that had empty promises, may God bring them to pass in the name of Jesus. You people that have been waiting for jobs, may God provide jobs in abundance. You that have been looking for money, may God give it to you now in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you because we are rich. We thank you because we are lively. We thank you because we are wealthy. We thank you because we are healthy. Somebody speak to God in these few minutes. Shatala prede kalapoya. Rama shitala brando seketeyaba. Rima sotolo bradoko sotoyaba. Tell him, Father, I thank you because mansions are mine. Tell him, Father, I thank you because nations are my inheritance. Tell him, Father, I thank you because you are my righteousness. Tell him, Father, I thank you because you are my results. Father, I thank you because you are quickening me. Any day that has been in my life, I thank you that it is done. Start to rejoice in the name of the Lord and tell him, my God, I thank you because all things are done. Tell him, my God, I thank you because your sickness is dissolved. Tell him, God, I thank you.
touching that which they said I cannot touch. I thank you that I've touched things. I thank you that I've touched millions of dollars, billions of pounds. I thank you that I'm moving to nations. I thank you that I'm in the USA. I thank you that I'm in California. I thank you that I'm in Canada. I thank you that I'm in America. I thank you that I'm in the UK. I thank you that I'm in Ireland. I thank you that I'm in Denmark. I thank you that I'm in Kenya. I thank you that I'm in South Africa. Happened. That is the power of a righteous man. The power of a righteous man. The Bible says it does what? It availeth much. Whatever you pray and seek as a righteous man, you are full of your answer. You are full of your answer. He cannot fail us. Shetelikayabadusa. Thank you, King of Glory. Thank you, King of Glory. Thank you, Lion of Judah. Thank you, El Shaddai. Somebody clap for God as though it has happened now. Shita Rapadosa. Repeskatayaba. Now you that have been sick, we need your testimonies. We need your testimonies. We need your testimonies. If it's cancer that has disappeared, we need them. We need them. We need them. We need them. God has quickened businesses. God has quickened finances in the name of Jesus. Receive it. Now I want to pray with you. You that has never received Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, your prayer can't avail as much. So if your prayer, if you want your prayer to avail much, you need to be righteous. And righteousness is a person. That is the Holy Spirit. That is Jesus Christ, the King of Peace. You just need to receive Him in your life, and He will give you that power. The power whereby your prayer can never fail to be answered. I want you to say, dear Lord Jesus, today I believe in my heart that you died and rose again, that I may be alive in you and you in me. From today, I am born again. Amen. If you've made that prayer, our numbers are on your screen. Contact us. Tell us that you have received Christ, and we shall be able to follow you up and pray for you, that may the Spirit of the Lord strengthen you. I always tell you, here we don't fall, in the name of Jesus. And those of you that are watching on YouTube, we are always live on Lighthouse Television every Friday, 3 p.m. 4:30 p.m. Tune in. And even you that are watching on Lighthouse Television, we are always live on Torch Fellowship, our lovely YouTube, every Tuesday from 8 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. We love you so much, and we are looking forward to seeing you again next week. God bless you till we meet again.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Bless the Lord that the gospel of this kingdom is being preached at large, and people are busy receiving this message. And this is great, for the Bible says that the gospel of this kingdom shall be preached to all nations, and then shall the end come. And why not? You can also be a good person and a great man in establishing the gospel. You that is not able to preach this gospel, the one able to preach, or the way the preachers in Torch are able to preach, you can also be able to preach it through sharing the link or through your giving. It is always good for a child of God to give. What we are not able to do, you're able to do. You maybe you're not able to preach, but we are able to preach. But you can be able to give. We are going to start up a project of giving, which is to be to the Word Investors. We are people. We need 100 people to be giving in 10,000 every Sunday. And if you want to be among those people that want to be giving in the 10,000, so that we are able to spread this gospel to all nations and to make people know that the gospel of this kingdom is still there, the true gospel, the true functional word of Almighty God is still there, the foundation of Christ that Christ laid, we're still doing it. And if you're there and you would love to be part of the 100 people that give in 10,000, it is so small, but it reaches out. Those that are abroad, it only takes $8 for you to take this gospel far per week. If you're a Word Investor and you would love to be among the Word Investors that give in 10,000 every Sunday, or $8 every Sunday, we thank the Lord that God has led you, or has led by the Spirit. If you're part of that team and you would love to give, please feel free to partner with us on the numbers and the different platforms that are displayed on our screen or on your screen, that you might be able. We have Airtel Money, we have Mobile Money, we have PayPal, we have Western Union, we have MoneyGram, we have Word Remit. Feel free to partner with us in any way as led by the Spirit of God. And we know that by that money that you're giving in weekly, it can be able to reach to over 10,000. The 10,000 you're giving in per Sunday, it's able to reach to over 10,000 people in a week. So if we can be able to have over millions of people giving in the 10,000, hundreds and thousands of people, that means we shall have thousands of hundreds and thousands of thousands of people being reached out through the giving that you give in. So the 10,000 that you're giving in every Sunday shall always be used to reach out to other people through these video broadcasts, through different television channels, through crusades, through different things. So the 10,000 you give, it is for the promotion of the gospel to other people. And those of you that are giving in right now as offertory, the numbers are also displayed on our screen. And I pray that the Spirit of the Lord shall surely bless you. Let me pray for you. Father, we thank you for the most generous people in the world that are giving in generously, that are giving in without being forced, but they are giving in out of the revelation of your word. And I give you praise that you've blessed them. In Jesus Christ's holy name, I've prayed and believed. Amen and amen.